So hello dear students, now we'll move on to the next part of the syllabus. As we have seen in the measure module 3, that is measurement of screw thread, that is part A. The part A we have seen the screw thread terminologies, and then measurement of major diameter, measurement of minor diameter, and now we are coming with measurement of effective diameter of screw thread. So in effective diameter of screw thread, we are having three methods, that is one wire method, two wire method, and three wire method. So also at the end we are studying which is the best wire we can use for the measurement of effective diameter. So we are having three derivations in this part. So first we will start from two wire method. So you can see in the notes they have given, it is a method of measuring pitch diameter of the screw thread. So this is the method we are using for measuring the pitch diameter of the screw thread. And normally these balls, or we can say these wires, are made up of hardened steel. This made up of hardened steel are placed between the flanks of the threads. So these are called as flanks. So we are placing one wire in the top and one wire in the bottom, and it is supported by anvils. So two anvils are supported here. And we have placed the wires with the alternative flanks. So not at the same way, it is placed in the alternative flanks. And this is the setup what we are used for measuring the effective diameter of screw thread. So now if you consider only one portion of this part, that is nothing but with anvil with one wire, so we can have an enlarged image here. So this is the enlarged image of this portion. So you can see here, it is a wire having a diameter of small d. So wire of diameter small d, and this h stands for the measurement between the two anvils. This is the measurement between the two anvils, and e stands for effective diameter. So effective diameter we have shown here. And y stands for, it is the measurement below the wires. Okay, see from wire 1 to the wire 2. So below portion, what is the distance between the this bottom portion, that we can say y. So we are having three dimension, that is h dimension over the wires, this y is dimension under the wires, and e stands for effective diameter of the screw thread. So our aim is to find out what is the effective diameter of the screw thread. Okay, so this h can be measured from this setup. So we are having this setup, we have micrometer in the top. So through the micrometer we can measure the value of h. And what is meant by y? So y is nothing but h, total distance is h, minus this diameter and this diameter. So it will be h is nothing but, see they have given, sorry, y is nothing but dimension under wires, that is h equal to dimension under wire, y equal to h minus 2d. So this small d stands for diameter of the wire. So e stands for effective diameter of the screw thread, y stands for dimension under wires, is a dimension over wire, and small d stands for diameter of the wire. Okay, so see the sketch properly. Say we have mentioned here a, b, c, 3 points, and we, from the center of the wire we have drawn one more line where it contacts. This point is taken as d and e, and then we have q in between. If you have drawn one line towards this root portion, that is the distance is taken as o and g. So now distance o d and o e is nothing but radius of the wire. Okay, radius of the wire is nothing but d by 2, and see here the angle is, total angle we are considered as theta, total angle is theta. So the half portion is nothing but theta by 2. So theta by 2, and h, y, e, and these are the different names what we are given for the points, that is a, b, c, and d, e. This is center point o, and this is g, and in between one point, there is nothing but q. See, in this method we need to find out what is e. Okay, so e is nothing but, the formula is, e is nothing but y plus p. So what is y here? Y is nothing but dimension under ys. So we have h minus 2d. So we know the value of h through the measurements. We know the value of d. It is standard value, diameter of the wire, so that we can find the value of y. So we can find the value of y, and plus p there. What is this p? P is nothing but pitch value. Okay, so p is nothing but pitch value. See here, there is p and small p are different. Okay, this is capital P. Capital P is nothing but pitch value. That small p stands for pitch of the screw thread. So I will show one more image. Okay, see, in this image I have wrote here, that is capital P stands for pitch value and the small p stands for pitch. So I have written here capital P. So the where capital P is nothing but pitch value. Okay, so now we need to find out what is effective diameter, that is y plus p. We know the value of y and we need to find out the value of capital P. Capital P is nothing but pitch value. See, this pitch value is equal to 2 into AQ. So as per the sketch, see, we can see the dimension of AQ. This AQ in the top head as well as in the bottom head, we are having AQ. So AQ plus AQ, that is nothing but 2AQ. So pitch value is nothing but 2 into AQ. So from this figure, we need to find out what is the value of AQ. So that is nothing but the derivation of this part. Okay, so E is equal to Y plus 2 into AQ. So we need to find out what is AQ. So now we need to consider one triangle. So from the figure, consider a triangle OEG. See here, O and E and G. So this is a right angle triangle. See here, OGE. So this right angle triangle. See here, what is the angle? Angle is theta by 2. Angle is theta by 2 and OEG. This triangle we have to consider. See OEG. Okay, now we need to consider one angle, that is sine theta by 2. The angle is nothing but theta by 2 there. Okay, so that you need to take sine theta by 2. Sine theta is nothing but opposite by hypotenuse. So opposite side is nothing but OE divided by hypotenuse is OG. OG is the longest distance, so you can take it as hypotenuse. So it will be OE divided by OG. So OE stands for what? Just you can see, OE is nothing but radius of the diameter of the wire. Radius of the wire is nothing but D by 2. Radius of the wire is nothing but D by 2. So we need here OG. So OG we can take this side. So OG, it will be OE divided by sine theta by 2. So OE divided by sine theta by 2 we have taken. OE stands for what? OE stands for D by 2. It is the diameter by 2. So D by 2 into 1 by sine theta by 2. 1 by sine theta by 2 is nothing but cosecant theta by 2. So now from this is the one value we have taken it as 1. Okay. So now we need to consider one more triangle, that is QCG. So QCG. So this triangle we can see here, QCG, this triangle. Okay. So this triangle. So from this triangle, we need to have one more value, that is tan theta by 2. Okay. So this angle is theta by 2. Tan theta by 2 we have to take. That is tan theta by 2 equal to opposite by adjacent. So opposite by adjacent. Opposite is nothing but QC. Adjacent is QG. QC by QG. So we need the value of QG. So QG is equal to QC by tan theta by 2. Okay. QC by tan theta by 2. QC. And 1 by tan theta by 2 is nothing but cot theta by 2. That later we have a conversion. Okay. Before that, we need to know the value of BC. What is this BC? So see here, BC stands for, it is the half of the pitch value. Okay. So what is meant by pitch? Pitch is nothing but the distance between the one crest to the another crest, which is nothing but consecutive crest. The distance between the two consecutive crest, we can call it like pitch. Okay. So the distance between from here to here is nothing but pitch, and distance from distance, half of this distance we can see it over here. half of the distance. It's nothing but one crest to another crest is P. So half we can consider till here, that is half P by 2. Okay, this P by 2 distance we can found as BC. See, if you continue this line from B to one more point till here, so that it will becomes one pitch. So this is half and this is again half. So it will be BC stands for P by 2. Okay, BC stands for P by 2. See, pitch by 2. Pitch is nothing but distance between the one crest to another crest, nearest crest. Okay, so its pitch divided by 2 is nothing but BC. Okay, so hence QC is equal to, so QC stands for, this is again half of the BC, right? So QC is nothing but again half of the BC. So half into BC. So BC we have written as P by 2. So half into P by 2, this is nothing but P by 4. Okay, so we have got the value of BC. So we have got the value of QC. So this is QC. We need QC. QC is nothing but P by 4. So QC is equal to P by 4 into 1 by tan theta by 2 is nothing but cot theta by 2. So this is the one more equation what you have to consider. First one is OG, that is D by 2 cosecant theta by 2. And one more equation is QG, that is P by 4 cot theta by 2. Okay. So by using these two relations, what is our final aim is nothing but we need to find out the distance of AQ. What is the value of AQ? Okay. If you find the value of AQ, we can find out effective diameter. See here, E is equal to Y plus 2AQ. So I think you have understood till here. This is one triangle we have to consider. That is this triangle OGE. And one more triangle we have to consider. That is QCG. See, in the first triangle we have to consider sine theta by 2. In the second triangle we have to consider tan theta by 2. So first one is sine theta by 2. Next one is tan theta by 2. Later, what we have to do? We need to BC stands for P by 2. Okay, BC stands for P by 2. That you have to take it to consider, and we have to convert QG as P by 4 cot theta by 2. So these are the two relations what you have got. Okay. Now from the figure we know that OG. So OG is equal to OA plus AG. OA plus AG. So we need the value of AG because we need to find out the value of AQ. So AG is equal to OG minus OA. So what is meant by OA here? OA is again the radius of the wire. Again the radius of the wire. So we can say, and OG, what is the value of OG? OG we already found out, that is D by 2 cosecant theta by 2. So now we need to substitute here. AG is equal to D by 2 cosecant theta by 2 minus D by 2. So I have taken D by 2 as common, D by 2 cosecant theta by 2 minus 1. Okay. So later QG is equal to AQ plus AG or QA plus AG. That is QG is nothing but shear QG. Okay. QG, we are having two points. That is QG is nothing but QA plus AG. QA plus AG. Okay. So we have the value of AG. That is we have found from here. And we need to find out AQ. So AQ or OQA is equal to, is nothing but QG minus AG. So QG minus AG. This QG also we already found. That is the value of QG is P by 4 cot theta by 2. You substitute these values. So now we need AQ or QA, that is equal to QG is nothing but P by 4 cot theta by 2 minus AG we already found, again D by 2 whole bracket cosecant theta by 2 minus 1. Okay, so now P is equal to, we already know that this P stands for 2 into AQ. So 2 into AQ. So P is equal to 2 into AQ. 2 you multiply with this equation so that it will be, we'll have one more image. So in the next image you can see. Yeah, so in this image we can see, if you multiply this with, if you multiply with the 2, it will becomes P by 2 cot theta by 2 minus, it becomes, if you multiply 2, it will be D into cosecant theta by 2 minus 1. Okay, So same thing here, p by 2 cot theta by 2 minus d into cosecant theta by 2 minus 1. Okay. See, this is the final formula what you are obtaining from this derivation. After that, this is the value of, what is this value? It is nothing but pitch value. Okay. So now if we consider a metric thread, so we know that metric thread is having the angle of, thread angle of 60 degree. Hence, p is equal to p by 2. In the place of theta, you need to substitute the value of 60 degree. So if you substitute 60 here, so it becomes 30, and you substitute means again 30. If you find, if you substitute these values in the calculator, you will get capital P is equal to 0.866 pitch minus D. Okay, normally in the final examination, they will ask determine the pitch value for metric thread, or may they ask only till here. Okay, these are the two steps what you have to do. Suppose if they ask for widthward thread, the theta value will be 55 degree. So if you substitute the theta as 55 degree, so that you will get this value. So but you should remember till here, that is p is equal to 0.866 p minus d. See, what is this p? This capital P stands for pitch value, and this small p stands for pitch of the thread. So both are different. Capital P is nothing but pitch value, and small p is nothing but pitch of the thread. Okay, so this is about two wire method. I hope you have understood. But here the main thing here it is, you need to draw the setup how we are setting for two wire method, and you need to know the sketch of this. If you know the sketch, you can solve it very easily. Here we have two triangles you have to consider. In the first triangle, it is sine theta by 2. In the second triangle, it will be tan theta by 2. Okay. So after only the final answer is, we are finding what is the value of AQ or QA. If you find QA, the whole derivation is over. Okay. This is about two wire method. So I think you all are at home, right? So because you see now coronavirus is spreading exponentially. If you be at home, you can avoid spreading in exponential manner. See, and also thing is, you may be thinking that we have enough immune power. If you go out, it will not spread for me, or it will not cause anything for me. But the problem is, you may be become the transmit from you to another. In the sense, maybe for the elder people, or for the who are already having some illness, you can spread for them, right? So they may be, it will affect for them very seriously. That's why I'm telling, please be at home and study these things. Okay, this is very important. I won't repeat this these classes or whatever this derivations again in the class. You have to understand. If you have any doubts, you can ask. Okay. So later in the next video, I will explain regarding three wire method. So I need a little time. So after that, I will explain this three wire method as well as the best size of wire. Okay. So thank you all.